Should we do this?
Do you have a mentor or someone who inspired you?
Yes, I do. Berry Gordy, Diana Ross, Thomas Edison, Walt Disney, James Brown, Jackie Wilson.
And what have you learned from them?
I learned a lot from them about how to be a visionary, how to be creative, how to be persistent, how to be determined, how to have a will of iron, and to never give up no matter what, you know?
Oh, that's good. And what was your first job in the music industry, and how did you get it?
First job, probably, I don't remember back that far. I was around 6 years old. It was
the first time you...
Mr. Lucky's, I think it was a club. Yeah, Mr. Lucky's. We performed there.
And how'd you get the job?
I don't know. My father would know. I was too little.
What was your first break and the first great thing that ever happened to you?
The real big break was when Motown signed us. Mm-hmm. We auditioned in Detroit, and Berry Gordy invited, I mean, all of our favorite stars that we saw as kids in this little town, Indiana. Mm-hmm. Diana Ross, Smokey Robinson, mm-hmm. you know, The Miracle, The Temptations, and Stevie Wonder. Everybody was there, and it was next to his indoor pool. It's this huge mansion, marble everywhere, and we performed, and they just went crazy. They loved it. He says, boys, you're signed.
Really?
Yeah.
And you remember that day?
Oh, I remember it.
And what elements of your job make you want to go to work every day when you do?
I want to work every day. Just the idea of creating worlds. It's like taking a canvas, an empty canvas, you know, clean slate.
Right.
And give you paint. And you just color and paint and create worlds.
Right.
You know, I just love that idea. Anything. And have people see it and they're awe-inspired.
Right.
After they see it.
Okay, what qualities most help you get to where you are today?
Faith and determination. And practice.
Right. Practice makes perfect. Okay, what would you have done differently in your career if you knew then what you know now? If you knew what you knew now.
Yeah, I know. Practice more.
Practice more?
I practice a lot.
You practice a hell of a lot. But you're going to practice more? Oh, my God. Okay. What is your greatest lesson learned?
Not to trust everybody. Mm. Not to trust everybody in the industry. There's a lot of sharks. And record companies steal. They cheat. Mm-hmm. You have to audit them. Mm-hmm. And it's time for artists to take a stand against them, mm-hmm. because they totally take advantage of them. Totally. They forget that it's the artists who make the company, not the company make the artists. Without the talent, the company would be nothing but just hardware. I mean, just, you know, and it takes that real good talent that the public wants to see.
Mm-hmm. What are some of your favorite albums?
My favorite albums would be Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker Suite, Claude Debussy's Greatest Hits, which is, you know, Clair de Lune and Arabesque,
mm-hmm.
and Afternoon of a Faun.
Mm-hmm.
I love Marvin Gaye's What's Going On,
mm-hmm.
James Brown Live at the Apollo, Sound of Music. I love Rodgers and Hammerstein. I love the great show tune writers very much. And I love Holland Dozier Holland from Motown. They were geniuses. So many great writers. So many great ones.
And any other great albums, like contemporary albums?
Great albums. It's hard because albums today, they have one or two good songs and the rest stink, you know.
Or older stuff. I mean, you could be like Marvin Gaye. Like,
okay, yeah.
Cool. Or Sly.
Sly and the Family Stone, I like everything they do. Stevie Wonder is a genius. Everyone. Talking Book. I love the one where he did Living for the City. I forget the name of it.
Yeah.
Fantastic. I think that was Songs in the Key of Life.
Yeah. Right.
Fantastic. Uh-huh. And hearing his music made me say to myself, I can do this, and I think I can do this on an international level.
Really?
And then when the Bee Gees came out in the 70s, that did it for me. I cried listening to their music. I knew every note, every instrument.
This broken heart.
Yeah. How can you mend that one? This broken heart. And how can you stop the rain falling down? I love that.
How can you stop
the sun from shining?
Accent. When the world go round.
I love that stuff. When they hit Saturday Night Fever, man, that did it for me. I said, I gotta do this. I gotta do this. I know I can do this. And we hit with Thriller. I just started writing songs like Billie Jean. I wrote Beat It, starting something. Just writing, and it was fun.
Any posters in your bedroom as a kid, and of who?
Yeah, Brooke Shields. Everywhere. My sisters would get jealous and tear them off the wall.
Really? Brooke Shields? Okay. Yeah. What are the great shows that you've seen, concerts? Or even just shows?
James Brown. Jackie, with the real entertainers, man. The real ones make you get goosebumps.
It was James Brown where? Where'd you see him?
We used to have to go on stage after him because he would come on, and we would come on amateur hour.
Yeah.
So I'd be in the wings just studying every step. And,
on TV? On a TV show?
No, like at the Apollo.
Amateur hour at the Apollo. Mm-hmm. And you saw him perform?
Yeah, Jackie Wilson.
And Jackie Wilson?
Delphonics, Temptations.
But the show, do you remember one show where you saw the Temptations? Yeah.
Yeah.
It was there a show that you saw that you were like, oh my God.
James Brown, Jackie Wilson.
It's James Brown, Jackie Wilson shows. At the
It made me cry.
At the Apollo?
Yeah, it made me cry.
Wow.
I've never seen nothing like that. That kind of emotion, kind of fever, feeling. It was like on another higher spiritual plane they were on. They were like in a trance. And they had the audience in the palm of their hand. I just love how they could control them like that. That kind of power. Mm. When they sing, they have tears running down their face. Oh.
Because they just...
It gets so into it, you know.
Wow.
Woo!
Now, what are some of your favorite songs?
Favorite songs of all time?
Yeah.
I love Burt Bacharach very much. Any Motown, Beatles like Eleanor Rigby, Yesterday, any of the Supremes, all that stuff is great. I think the 60s had some of the best melodies of all time. Between Peter, Paul, and Mary, and, you know, all those people, I thought they were great. Mamas and the Papas were wonderful. And, Drifters, Go A Little Further Back, but I love it. It's on the boardwalk, on Broadway, is ingenious.
Yeah.
Simple. The simple ones are the best, I think. I love Alfie. You know that one. So beautiful.
Wow.
There's so many.
So many.
Like movies. So many great movies.
So listen to a few things that could be helpful to someone breaking into the music business.
Believe in yourself, study the greats, and become greater. Mm-hmm. And be a scientist. Dissect. Mm-hmm. Dissect.
Yeah. When you said it before, you said something else. Don't give up. No. What did you say? I don't remember.
No matter what, I mean, I don't care if the whole world is against you or tease you or say you're not going to make it. Believe in yourself. No matter what.
No matter what.
Some of the greatest men that have made a mark on this world were treated like that. You know, you're not going to do it. You're not going to get anywhere. They laughed at the Wright brothers. They laughed at Thomas Edison. Mm-hmm. They laughed at Walt Disney. They made jokes of Henry Ford. They said he was ignorant. He didn't have a college degree. because he dropped out of school. Mm-hmm. Disney dropped out of school. They even took Ford to court to prove his intelligence. That's how far they went. Yeah. And these are men that shaped and changed our culture, our customs, the way we live, the way we do things. Mm-hmm. And I think God plants little seeds through people on the earth. And I think you're one, I'm one, to bring some bliss, some escapism, some joy, some magic. Because without entertainment, what would the world be like, you know? But what would it really be like? It'd be a totally different world for me. I love entertainment. And my favorite of all is film. The power and magic of movies. It's the greatest, it's the most expressive of all the art forms. I think it touches the soul. Music and movies is the most expressive. It's like, almost like it's like religion. You get so involved, so caught up. You go in the theater a different person when you come out. Yeah. And they've affected you that way. That's powerful. That's powerful, man. I think they're strong. I love that. And you got them, you know. And
you make them feel a certain way. They relate to it.
They live it.
They live it with you, yeah.
They forget their
shit. The experience of watching a movie affects their life.
And it can change their
That's what I was saying. Remember about seeing Star Wars when I was 7 years old?
Yeah.
It's a different experience for Paris or Prince seeing You know? It's amazing. Even though it's the same movie, at the moment when you're a certain age and when you see it and what's going on in the world at that time, and it's the first time you ever see something like that, and it's like, movies affect you. And just like it's listening to hearing a song or seeing an artist perform. Getting to see James Brown, and that moment of tears coming out of your eyes is different.
I can't tell you how incredible.
That's amazing.
And I just love the great entertainers, the great performers, the great showmen.
Yeah.
The great the storytellers, and just watching them, you just mesmerize.
Oh yeah.
You get caught up in it. I love it. One spotlight, baby.
Yeah. Frank Sinatra.
Yeah. Those guys are cool. And Sammy Davis, and I just love it. The whole thing. It's magic.
Yeah.
It's real magic.
What about James Brown in the hot tub? Hot tub!
That's true.